most. I know we see the external stuff, we see the before and afters. What you don't see is how much it works in here on people. That's what it changes. So I don't want you to get discouraged if you didn't hit the goal that you wanted to hit in 90 days because you've got your whole life up ahead of you. It is not about how fast, how quick you can achieve something. That smile on my face, laughing so hard behind stage, because I didn't care if I placed at all. I really didn't. I just didn't care to place. You're going to place. I'm like, that's cool. I love this body. Just walking around. That's awesome. But I placed. That was fun. But what was more fun is who I became. I became confident. I loved this game that I was in. I didn't care about stretch marks anymore because I brought kids into this world. I just loved myself. And if you can love yourself through this process, I promise you'll show other people that they have permission to start loving themselves too, to start where they are. There is an I in team. Do you guys know that? There is an I in team. Everyone, when I grew up on soccer teams, said there was like, there's no I in team. I always believed that. So there got a point in my business. I was hitting success club every month. I was sharing. I was inviting. The last day of the month, like Amy said, I'm like, who haven't I talked to in preschool that I can reach out to today that maybe would buy a job? Anybody? Haven't missed anybody? Right? Sometimes that is tiring. Let's be honest. We're not going to sugarcoat stuff. You get tired of trying. Life sometimes gets hard. And even though I said out loud, I want to bring Adam home, those were just words at the time. Because he hadn't said yes yet. He's like, maybe. I have kids. I know that means no. That didn't mean yes. So I just kept doing the things that I liked doing every single day, but I got tired. And I wanted to slow down. And I wanted to watch Netflix. I just wanted to binge on Netflix. And so I started doing that. And as I started doing that more, and as I stopped showing up more, people stopped messaging my inbox as much, saying, you're inspiring me. Instead, I was getting messages of, I missed you. Where have you been? Haven't seen you a lot. Nick, I'm watching Netflix. I don't know. You should watch this show, it's really good. But I got tired. And then my team started to get tired. I'm like, wait, what happened? I wanted to take a break. You guys can't take a break. Yeah, I want to take a break. But they wanted to take a break because speed of the leader is speed of the path. There is an I in team, and the I in team is you. It's you that has to show up every single day, even when you're tired. It's you who has to lead from the front. You can't cheer me from the back. I tried. My numbers started to go down. People stopped joining challenge groups. At one point in Summit, I retract this statement. At one point at Summit, I said, I don't do challenge groups anymore. I'm burnt out. I don't do challenge groups anymore. That's the worst thing you can ever do as a coach, is to not do a challenge group. Because when you don't do a challenge group, you're not helping people. You're not serving. So if you're tired of doing certain challenge groups, change it up. Get creative. I had to start creating financial freedom challenge groups of the Daybreak budget system. I had to start doing challenge groups of the five love languages so people could have better communication in their marriages and understand how their other partner felt loved. I had to teach people how to let kids cope with deployments. I had to find out, what can I do a challenge group with that wouldn't make me tired right now, but can still serve and help other people. Now I'm running challenge groups like all the time in fitness. But the reason why I was burnt out was because I allowed myself to stop. I allowed myself to slow down. So by no means am I not saying you shouldn't have any balance and you should go up 1,000% all the time. Balance is key. But don't ever allow yourself to slip behind your team to where you're cheerleading from the back. Together, everyone achieves more. Man, I used to take on so much. So much, and I didn't have to. People all the time would say, I know Adam just left today for a 10-month deployment. Can I take the kids for you today? Can you have some alone time? I'm like, no, I'm good. And then I'm like, do we have wine anywhere in this house? Where is this? Right? I should have said yes. Take the kids to the park for an hour. It's the same thing with your team. But you have to be willing to step up and say, what can I do to help serve this team of ours? This isn't my business, this is our business. Even when he was deployed, this is ours. Annie, this is our team. Annie would say, can I take over a call for you this week? Because I see that you're traveling. I love you, right? Do that for your upline, and for the people that are on your team? What can I do to help make us better, stronger, faster, together? Create systems, because more brains together are more powerful than one. She comes up with ideas that I would never think of. So many of the girls on my team that are here today. You have to combine forces and show up. Smart. Are you smart? Anyone feel smart here? I did not always. And sometimes I would make a goal, and I would think to myself, that's dumb. Why did I do that? You know what I think is a dumb goal when people say, I want to be healthy. Okay, eat a piece of lettuce. Did you achieve it? I don't know. Because healthy is, that's a fraud. I don't know what you mean by that. So let's talk about one of the systems that I implement for every step of my life. Is it smart? Is your goal specific? So when you say, I want to be healthy, when someone reaches out to you and say, I love your videos, I want to be healthy, I want you to use this form method back when you talk to people. You say, I don't know what to say to people when they reach out to me or what questions to ask. Smart. Everything they say to you, ask yourself, is this smart? If it's not, teach them how to make it smart. Give them direction on where they need to go. So number one, is your goal specific? Someone says, I want to get healthy. Great. What does that mean to you? What does healthy mean to you? Do you want to lower your cholesterol? Do you want to lose 10 pounds? Do you want to get off medication? Specific questions. I want to be dieting. Okay, why? Why do you want to be dieting? What's that going to do for you? Be specific. Is your goal measurable? I want to be healthy. Well, we determine if I eat a piece of lettuce right now, am I healthy? No. I can't determine that because that's not measurable. So I want to lose 10 pounds. So when I lose 3, can I measure how close I am to that? Yes. So every time you talk to someone, make sure it's something that they can measure. Do you have an action plan? Do they have a system? Do they have P90X? Do they have any of our programs, 21 Day Fix? Do they have an action plan? They do. You have to help them follow through it. With your business, do you have an action plan? I know a lot of you are like, girl, I try to create an action plan every day to get successful, and it is not working. Keep trying. Tweak it. Ask other people what's on their action plan. Do you have a power hour? Hi, squirrel syndrome. It's a real thing. I swear it is. I will be on something 1 second, 2 seconds later, I'm like, shoes. Did you see those shoes on the side of my Facebook page? Let's talk about this real quick. Squirrel syndrome, it's real. I have to have power hours or I get nothing done in my life. So what's the power hour look for you? For me, first 10 minutes of every day of work, I've got to listen to Stephen Furtick. Personally for me, I have to fill my heart and my head with God first before I can open that inbox, or I might use some choice words. gotta love me some Jesus first. Next, I go back into my dad online office. What's new? What's in the breaking news? Anything cool that I need to know about, to talk to my team about? Maybe some specials? After that, I'm making a post for the day, or I'm brain dumping. I love brain dumping. I don't know if you guys saw my training on this. I did one, I think it's 2 years ago, maybe it's on YouTube. But I created this thing called brain dumping. And it's where you sit with some just quiet, inspirational music to you, no words, and you write down anything that comes out of your head. Words, memories, people, whatever. And then later, when you're in the right mindset, you go further on each of those things. Why did I write that down? What did I want to talk about that? What did I want to teach about that? I can create content for 30 days on the brainstorming in 1 hour. It's just brainstorming. So you have to have an action plan. Is your goal realistic? Now that depends on you. Is your goal realistic? If you would have asked me when I was 20 grand and said I wanted to bring them out of home, at the time to me that wasn't going to stay. But when I started doing a lot of these things, I started believing that it was. And when I put an action plan and say, okay, we've got to figure this out. We've got to put a deadline date on this, because we have this awesome team member on this team and that can be hard. You want to wake up call in life that time is the only thing that you can't back? Lose a teammate. Shortly after, another one of his teammates committed suicide. Hard hit. Wake up, call me. If I'm tired, so what? You gotta keep going. You got a why that makes you cry. You got something that's important to fight for. You fight for it. So you have to set something that's realistic to you and what you're willing to make that happen. So to me, I wanted to replace his income. It was never in my wildest dreams a goal to say, I'm gonna be the millionaire circle, or I'm gonna be whatever. Didn't matter to me. I just wanted to serve. I wanted to help people. I wanted to feel like I had a purpose, I was making a difference. If you say to yourself, but I don't have a why that makes me cry, you do. It doesn't have to be a spouse. It doesn't have to be retirement, because first of all, that has to be their choice. That was his choice. I wasn't some savior that came on a white horse and saved the day. His choice that he wanted to be home with us, to be a family. So you have to decide what your realistic goal is. I'll talk to coaches on the first day, and I'm like, so what do you want to do with coaching? They're like, 15 start next month. It's game on. Let's do it. You did it, I'm gonna beat you. I'm like, love the spirit, love the fire, go team. It's not gonna happen. Full pressure. Sorry, love you, I gotta tell you the truth. How do we shoot for diamond? Why don't we do something that's realistic, and we'll reverse engineer that together on what that takes to happen. Do you have a time limit? A lot of people say, take your time, enjoy life. For some of you, that may be true. For me, I didn't feel like I could do that. I felt like our time was ticking every single day. He was in Afghanistan, and when he came home, I knew our schedule, because it was a habit, right? He was gone 10 months out of almost every year for 5 years straight. Sometimes he'd come home from an appointment, and I would think I had 2 months with him, and he'd be like, babe, I've got bad news. They just told me we're leaving on Friday. I'm like, but that's tomorrow. He's like, yeah, sorry. I had a time limit, because we didn't have a lot of time. So maybe you do, maybe you don't. But you've got to set a time to your goals. I'm going to achieve to complete the 21-day fix program in 21 days. Guys, that's 21 days. When people tell me they fail that, I'm like, we need to sit down and talk. It's 21 days of your life. Give your all to one of our programs. Please represent what these programs can really do for people. Because when you cheat on that program, when you go to McDonald's and you fill your body with toxic, genetically modified, not going to say a cuss word, bad stuff, awful stuff, that's not what our programs do for people. That's not the life we want to live. Set a time limit. Dun, 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 dun. Personal development. Fill your head with personal development. It's not quack stuff, I promise. He thought that. Now we have like a million books. Fill your head with personal development. Whatever it is you're struggling with, that's what you should read. A lot of people say, what's the best book? The best book is whatever it is that you're struggling with right now inside of your head. These are some of my favorites. This is the collage of a lot of our homecomings and our leavings, right? We have to have that final hug, goodbye, say okay, I'll see you soon. You've got to put pictures up like that around your house that remind you what it is that you're fighting for. Because there were days that it was hard, that it was easy for me to forget. That it would be easy to say, you know what, the military does cover our housing, we have health insurance, we're grateful for what we have. It's not too bad. We can keep pushing through for one more year. We could do this for 6 more months. So you have to put reminders up of what it is that you're fighting for. And for me, I had to decide that I wanted to say good morning to him more than I wanted to say goodbye. It was that simple. You have to make a choice that's that simple. And although it's just a sentence, to me, it hit me in my heart every single morning, because there was no other feeling than waking up in a bed without someone beside me. So 10 months out of every year, I slept on the couch. Couch is to me the most comfortable. If you ever want to invite me over and you don't have a guest room, it's cool. I'll take the couch. I love couches. But there are times even when you're consistent in the business. The year that I decided to go all in, I made top 10. Got to go on an amazing trip to Argentina with Jeff and a lot of corporate. I was on cloud 9. My team was taken off. We had 15 superstar diamonds. Everything was awesome. And then I started to slow down again. And I made my goal board. I was real excited. I didn't think I slowed down. I made my goal board and I showed my husband. And I was like, what do you think about my goal board? He goes, true. I'm like, yeah. He's like, I feel like I have LeBron James on my team and you're playing like an injured Caleb. I was like, you think I'm like LeBron James? That's the first thing I heard. A lot of people were like, you think I'm an injured player? I was like, you think I'm like LeBron James? He's awesome. He balls on that court. That was our bonding time watching the Cavs. That was the one thing that we had that we could always talk about on Skype. So that was a wake-up call to me, that he thought I was like LeBron James. He thought that I had that work ethic. He reminded me of my own greatness. And a lot of times you need people in your corner to remind you of your own greatness. So talk to your coach, build a relationship with them, form with other people, because you have to be reminded when you're not playing like LeBron. Don't let your time be your excuse making your reason. So I know some of the things that I say, if you follow me on videos, Adam and I, you say things for face value a lot of times. And I want to end it with this. A lot of times we don't have people in our corner, right? We want our friends to join our groups. We want our mom to just trust us. Mom, just listen to me. Drink the Shakeology. That's what my mom's doing. Mom, I love you. You're probably watching live. She's a coach. Guys, she killed it. My mom's in her 50s. She's a one-star and a coach, almost two-star. She rocks it. But she still says shit.